So when you're going to Placentia, the chances are you're going to fly into the international airport, you're going to clear customs and immigration, you're going to go get on a plane with Tropic or Maya and fly to Placentia. As you guys know, I live in San Pedro. I keep my car in Belize City. So if I ever have to go to Mexico, if I'm ever going around Belize, I just fly into the municipal airport. One insider secret, if you are going to Belize City, I always go to Baked Coffee Shop. They have amazing lattes, amazing snacks. We hit Baked Up. Here's a little shot of what we did. What's going on, everyone? It's Will Mitchell here. Right now we're in Belize City at Baked Cafe, one of my favorite places to get a coffee or a snack or a tea. Today we're heading down to Placentia. We're gonna go have a nice weekend. Ruben?
You know the vibes.
After we left Baked, you have two options to get to Placentia. So number one is to take the Hummingbird Highway, which is the traditional way. Basically you go west from Belize City to Belmopan, then south from Belmopan down through Dangriga, Hopkins, and then into the peninsula, you're in Placentia. Option B is what we took on the way down, which is a major infrastructure development project. It's called the Coastal Highway. The Coastal Highway shaves 30 minutes off of the drive. So instead of going all the way to Belmopan, you go about halfway, then you start heading south. Huge, huge infrastructure project, like I said. The drive time on that is 3 hours. And if you're going with the Hummingbird Highway through Belmopan, it's 3.5 hours. So that's how you get down there. And it's a beautiful trip experiencing the great, you know, drive through Belize. Whether you're going all the way west, south, doesn't matter. It's always a nice experience. So now you're heading to Placentia and you gotta know where to stay. Well, look no further. For us, we stayed in an Airbnb called Swan Villa. It was really funky and eclectic. Some inspiration coming your guys' way for our people building. The other options that I like, Turtle Inn. It's owned by Francis Ford Coppola, the director of The Godfather. Just some of the best movies ever. Number two, CBC. It's a cool little boutique hotel. And number three is Maya Beach Hotel. They've got Maya Bistro there. We're gonna get into that in the food section. But the thing about Placentia that's very different from San Pedro is they actually have a lot of villas and not a lot of hotels. But let me show you guys the Swan Villa. Let's talk about the most important thing. If you're going to Placentia or going anywhere, you know it's the food. So let me give you my recommendations of restaurants, places to eat, bar food, everything. So when we arrived, we went to Rumfish. I had the lasagna. Rumfish is located right in town. Great location, great setting, great atmosphere. That lasagna was unbelievable. I also had the Thai curry fish and I had 100 appetizers. So food there was amazing. Couldn't recommend it more. The next day we hit up Maya Beach Hotel, their Maya Bistro there. That's probably arguably the best restaurant in Placentia. I don't know, it's very close with a few of these that I'm gonna tell you about. They have this egg McBistro sandwich. It's like an egg McMuffin, unreal. The whole breakfast menu, we almost tried one of everything. This was a serious try all the food foodie trip. After that, we hit up Above Grounds Cafe. Above Grounds Cafe is located again in Placentia. So that cafe has awesome coffee. They have bagels. It's a really chill, relaxed vibe. So if you want to go hang out, have a coffee, grab a bagel, that's the spot to do it. If you're looking for bar food, if you're looking for bar atmosphere, there's really one bar to go to in Placentia. It's Barefoot. Barefoot has an awesome beachfront setting, a bunch of drinks, bar food. It's really like snacks and stuff like that. So definitely check out Barefoot. If you want to get a few more recommendations off my list, the pizza at Turtle Inn, really good. And yeah, that was what we did from a food perspective. So when you're in Placentia, you don't have a ton of restaurants and bars. There's some great ones like the ones we talked about, but really what you're gonna wanna do is the natural aspect. So the reef is substantially further than in San Pedro, but they have a lot of great keys for that reason. So I love usually going out, spearfishing, checking those keys up. This trip though, we wanted a jungle vibe. So we went to Coxcomb National Park. It's a beautiful national park. You drive in, you go to the visitor center there. They have a little educational area where they explain the wildlife. You pay your park fee. And we chose to do Tiger Fern Trail, which is a 4 kilometer trail to this double waterfall at the end. There's an awesome hilltop at one point. So we walked in there, it was raining a bit. There was definitely some slipping and falling. So if you are looking to hike a trail, be prepared because I'm more of a jog on the beach kind of guy. I wasn't really ready for this. And I definitely scuffed up my white shoes along the way, but it was definitely worth it. Let me show you guys about that experience.
You remind me of the kind of love from 96, from my lips on a TV screen, shooting my favorite wet dream. Now I'm waking up and I'm thinking of you all the time. Got this pounding in my chest. Ain't caught feelings quite like this since I was 16. I would dream about a girl on top of me. White tee, nothing on underneath. I was 16 nowadays. Girl, it's you that got me crazy. I'm trying to find the words to explain. Yeah.
We're out here, bro. Oh, am I? Yeah, I'm gonna love this part, I bet.
Stuck in a teenage dream. You got that something about you. Wanna get in between. Think you know what I mean. My rich or green.
It took, they say 40 minutes. Probably took us an hour. The trail's pretty serious, but at the end, you get this. So that's it, you're leaving Placentia, but don't cry guys, because when you're on your way out, going back up to the airport to fly back to San Pedro or wherever you're going, there's a butterfly sanctuary along the way. Butterflies just make everything better. So let's end this video by looking at some butterflies.
Till I saw a smiley face, lifting my tongue and French kissed until the colors changed. Ooh, I was liberated. Never seen the sun and moon so illuminated. All the days it starts to bloom when I'm with my baby. Peach and mango spinning on the rusty Winnebago. Got me on a trip to Vegas. Snaps in the blue sky, turning to stars. She's clap on my waist in the back of the car. She breathes in my brain waves, calm to fly. When she speaks, I let go of the past. So come here, flower girl, just breathe.